What's up, ladies and gentlemen? This is the captain, SS Georgie, with another patch overview of over Fortnite Battle Royale. Today we're going to be talking about a very small, well, I don't want to call it a very small patch. It's a small patch because there's not a huge deal of new things, but it's a new patch. So new patch means new things, so let's get right to it, alright? So version 1.8.1, so it's a minor patch. You see 1.8 was released last week with a huge amount of improvements, but I have noticed a bunch of different bugs that I've been like constantly been reporting to Epic. Hopefully some of those bugs were fixed, so let's get right to it. Voice chat improvements. Take control of your communication with your option to mute individual players located in the audio tab on the settings screen. So. Yeah, so there's been times that I've been in squad games and people are either speaking other languages, which there's nothing wrong with that, but they're just speaking amongst themselves and I have no clue what they're saying, so I would much rather like mute them, or there's people that have too much static or way too much background noise on their mic, and if it's like unpleasant or just straight up bothering, then I just don't even bother. I just sometimes I'm like, I wish they would just turn it off. So that's a really good addition. Quest drops. There are times when you may feel like you're unluckily spreading Fortnite as you can't get the last quest item. Well, it's your lucky day. We've increased quest item drop rates. Do they have a time limit? I've been finishing my quests like nothing. They're not really that difficult. I guess there's a time limit for it. Not entirely sure what that means. Alright, general. Options on cap frame. Oh, that's for console, so we're gonna skip that. Slurp trees can now. Okay, so let's go to gameplay. Slurp trees can now spawn as floor loot in addition to. Oh, thank god. I rarely, like, very rarely find slurp trees. Like, once, maybe every 6-7 games, and that's if. Maybe. So, I'm glad that they make that a little bit more common, because it's good, it's a really really good item, but it's not OP. It's considered epic, but I think the shield pots are a little bit more valuable, and the medkits, of course, they heal you back to full, but you also don't like to waste them if you have bandages, so it definitely has its place, but I don't think it's super overpowered. That being said, I'm glad they're gonna, hopefully this increases the spawn time rate for it. Fix the issue that allows players to consume slurp juice. I've never had that issue. Fix the effects of slurp juice persisting from pregame phase. Wow, so if I found a slurp juice in the pregame phase, I would start with a 25 shield. That's busted. Okay, fix an issue which causes other players' ladders to appear sideways. I haven't had that yet. Actually, I have seen that with the umbrella, where they're like, they look like Mary Poppins. They have the, like, they have it like this. I thought that was like a, I guess that's just maybe just from the angle I'm seeing it, but I have seen that. Supply drop balloons now take damage when shot from below. Like the crate? I don't know. I've never tried to take it down. Fix an issue which caused revives to be interrupted if another DPNO. Not entirely sure what the DPNO. Oh, if there's just like around you, it would stop it? I can see how that would be an issue. Just to the camera while holding the pumpkin rocket launcher. The camera angle previously interfered with players' crosshairs. I do see that, actually. I'm gonna have to go to one of my replays to see, because one of the two games that I won yesterday was heavily because of the rocket launcher. Improved stability of the matchmaking system. Yeah, I got like the same squad guys like two or three times in a row. I don't know if that's what it means, or maybe just like how long it takes. Performance. So I remember the devs had talked about how they wanted to improve the performance of the game in lower end machines. I have a gaming computer with a pretty high end specs. Well, for the time right now, they're old parts, but it's still high end specs in my opinion. And I know people that are playing on Macs or on laptops are having a really hard time running it. So Let's see, let's, we'll see. Various optimizations to player character animations for improved performance. That's cool. Fix various hitches during gameplay due to assets being loaded at runtime. Fix server network like Crane and Flare attempted to regenerate much after timing out or being kicked. Never had those issues, but I'm glad. These are a lot of bug fixes. Remember, this game's still in early access, so bug fixes are good. UI, team members listed next to the options menu. Listed, is this like in-game? Because I know the teammates are like on the top left. I don't know if they changed it to like the top right. I don't know. We'll have to see it in-game. Screen shows the number of players each team member has. Oh, so it's sort of like... Oh, okay. So it'll give you like, sort of like in Call of Duty, like kills and... Yeah, just how many kills it has. Toggle voice muting, that's good. That's really good, so... If you want to mute them, that's cool. So if you want to individually mute a team member. Xbox One players, teammate, the same thing. Added confirmation prompt when equipping items in the locker. Oh, okay. So like, are you sure? I guess. Changes to the sensitivity sliders will probably revert if the apply button is not used before closing the menu. Oh, so you have to click apply or it won't happen, basically. Change the description of V-Bucks to indicate that they can be used in both Save the World and Battle. Okay, so... excuse me. You can use it in both game modes, so if you buy it in Battle Royale, you can go to the other game and use them. Yeah, and this is the description that I'm not gonna bother reading. It's gonna be right there. I'm gonna be right here, so if you guys wanna read it, just go ahead. Fix the visual issue with the crown icon or party leader. Oh, okay. So, it'll make it clearer to see who's a party leader. Fix the consumable timer getting stuck on screen after transition from pregame to the battle bus. Consumable. It's never happened to me, but again, anything that's a bug fix and it's here, if you've experienced it, hopefully it's better now. Fix the leaderboard and stats page, which showed an incorrect time until refresh, so the system's clock was changed. Didn't have that issue. Fix consumable items being displayed as ranged weapons. I don't really look at them. I kind of figured out what guns I like and what guns I don't like. A revolver, a submachine gun. I know a friend of mine loves the revolver because he just goes for head with it. Not very successful all the time, but same. Fix an issue which caused control gun. Italian language. People in Italy, good news for you. Fix text that didn't fit on stats page in the Polish language. Alright. World, fix the gap in geometry that allows players to get below the terrain. Oh my god, that's actually happened to me a few times where I'm walking under, like, the surface, and that was really tilting. Holy crap, yeah. Minor environmental bug fixes. Floating trees, small scenes. Okay, bug fixes. Controller crouch and repair are no longer the same to put in combat pro config. Click R stick to. Okay, that's for control. I use mouse and keyboard. But I mean, I'm not trying to condescend the console people, but most of the people that I play with are PC. Most of the people I interact with are PC. So, but these are all good news for console people. If you play it on console, I know my brother could plays it on console and he loves it. Audio enabling voice chat while in match now adds the player. Enable voice chat while in match now adds the player to the voice channel. Okay. Wait. I thought that was automatic, I guess. Okay, I'm gonna just assume. I don't know what that means. I always have it on, and if people have mics, they have mics. Fix an issue that canceled music if players use the dance emote. Okay. Some challenges rebalance, play matches increase from 3 to 5. That's fine. Shotgun eliminations from 5 to 4. I didn't think that was too bad because I haven't gotten that one SMG. Thank God. Holy crap, 2 SMG, 5 SMG eliminations. I would probably die because I only kill like one tops 2, so 2's okay. Sniper eliminations, I actually did that one. I got like 7 or 8 yesterday. Finished it real quick. Existing progress and challenges, so if I have any progress, I will see, and I'm gonna have to start over, which is fine because now it's lower. The eliminate squad players challenge was renamed to limit opponents in squad mode to clarify how the challenge should be completed. Okay, cool. That is a lot more clear. I like that. Cosmetics hair will no longer clip through the recon expert outfit while moving. Hair will no longer clip through the skull trooper outfit while moving. Improved lighting for certain characters in matchmaking lobby. Alright, so a lot of bug fixes. So this patch was strictly on optimizing gameplay. I'm pretty sure they're going to do a lot more under the hood improvements. Yeah, so this was basically mainly for optimization, and I'm pretty sure they still have a lot more to work on. I know they said they don't feel comfortable with the state of the game right now. They want to make it better, and that's good. Having that drive to make it better is always good. And Save the World, I've never played the other game, and I'm one of those people that likes to go big or go home. I want to get the most expensive one if I'm gonna play this early access game. So leave a comment below if you would like to see me play the AI. I would more than gladly do it. I'll gather some money soon, hopefully. I'm gonna be working a lot soon, so if I manage to get the $90, I'm straight up just gonna buy it because I really like Fortnite Battle Royale, and this is what, like a zombies type mode. I love zombies types games. I used to play that in Black Ops and World at War, like way back in the Call of Duty days. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope you guys enjoyed the music. I'm kind of an old school guy. I really like Look Tonight. Salve Alton 80 from The Voice 2016, ladies and gentlemen. And with that, I leave you with my rundown of patch 1.8.1. See you guys in the next one. Peace.